combat mission is ending.
We will continue taking the greatest care to prevent harm to innocent civilians.
지난 2010년 10월 한 편의 다큐멘터리가 이라크 전쟁의 참혹한 진상을 적나라하게 들춰냈습니다.
And goodwill.
40여만 건에 이르는 미군의 이라크 전쟁 비밀일지를 분석한 이 다큐는 BBC나 ITV 같은 거대 방송사가 아닌 탐사보도국이라는 이름의 소규모 탐사보도 매체가 만든 것입니다. 지난 2010년 4월 런던 시티 대학에 자리 잡은 탐사보도국은 설립 첫 해부터 위키리크스와 만든 이 다큐로 앰네스티상을 수상하는 등 이름을 떨쳤습니다. 현재 이곳을 이끌고 있는 사람은 전 선데이 타임즈 탐사보도 에디터였던 크리스토퍼 허드입니다. 그는 진짜 탐사보도를 하기 위해 탐사보도국이 만들어졌다고 말했습니다.
A lot of investigative journalism in the newspapers is based upon whistleblowers or leaked documents or something of that sort. Now, there's absolutely nothing wrong with that sort of journalism whatsoever, but it's not investigative journalism. It's not one in which, you know, a large number of people over a long period of time spend the time really getting to the bottom of the story, discovering exactly what went on and who, if anything, if, and who did wrong, if wrong was done.
하지만 초기에는 의욕이 넘쳐 많은 기사를 생산하다 시행착오도 겪었습니다.
And it was really producing too many stories that were quite interesting but weren't really important. So what I wanted to do was to concentrate on a very small number of subjects which we would cover in depth and we would cover over a period of time. So we wouldn't just do one story and then forget about it. We would continue to follow that story, you know, until something changed.
탐사보도국이 집중적으로 파헤치고 있는 중요한 의제 가운데 대표적인 것이 미국의 드론, 즉 무인기 공격으로 인한 민간인 학살 문제입니다. 탐사보도국은 2년 가까이 이어온 드론 프로젝트를 통해 미국 오바마 정권 시기에 500명을 비롯해 파키스탄에서 3,000명이 넘는 민간인이 미국의 무인기 공격으로 숨졌다는 사실을 밝혀냈습니다. 뉴욕타임스와 BBC 등 세계적 언론사들도 이들의 드론 보도를 인용할 정도로 탐사보도국의 드론 추적 보도는 독보적인 것으로 정평이 나 있습니다.
Which there was a complete lack of transparency on behalf of the Americans. You know, they were claiming that this it was necessary to do this to defeat Al-Qaeda, but they were not providing the data on which one could make a judgment about whether it was effective or whether it was even legitimate. So our belief was that there was obviously a big gap here in public knowledge, and if we're to understand how it should be used, whether it should be used, we need to know as much as we possibly can about the way it's being used now. And there needs to be a transparency and accountability. And that was, you know, that was what was really driving us. And I think we've succeeded in bringing more transparency and bringing therefore a bit more accountability and making it part now of a public discourse.
인포메이션 앤 데이터 댓 이즈 어베일러블 인 더 퍼블릭 도메인 유 노우 댓 소 오비어슬리 데어 이즈 어 데어 이즈 어 베일러블 인 더 퍼블릭 도메인 앤 니얼리 올
information that was in the public domain. And nearly all, well, I can tell you, all of the information that we have acquired on the drones project has come from publicly available sources or our own on-the-ground reporting, right? Or we've sort of forced out of the mouths of politicians because we've kept going on about it. So that is not a project on which we have relied on whistleblowers inside or on secret information.
탐사보도국 설립을 도운 모 기관은 런던 골드스미스 대학에 있는 영국 탐사 저널리즘 센터입니다. 2003년 문을 연 이 비영리 기관은 탐사 저널리즘 확산과 탐사 언론인 교육 등을 주안점으로 삼고 있습니다. 센터 대표인 개빈 맥파디에는 영국의 대표적 탐사보도 프로그램인 BBC 파노라마를 포함해 모두 50여 개의 탐사 다큐를 제작한 베테랑 저널리스트입니다.
The Center for Investigative Journalism started because there was a huge crisis in British journalism. From 1985 to the present, there was almost no investigative reporting at all. It collapsed in the newspapers, and it collapsed completely on television. A group of us who were reasonably experienced investigators began training young journalists in our living rooms and in pubs. We would take them out and explain how things worked, what you do, how the law works, what the standards of truth-telling are and evidence are. And then a foundation heard about this and said, we'll give you some money to open an office.
탐사 저널리즘 센터는 탐사 취재 기법 등은 물론 권력에 민감한 사안을 다루는 기자들에게 스스로를 보호할 수 있는 방법 등을 가르치기도 합니다.
We run a summer school every year, and the summer school trains has trained 1,000 journalists in a lot of interesting things. We train covert recording, advanced law, computer security is now very big. We're the only ones who do that in a systematic way. Because reporters no longer have security. They no longer have privacy. A resource who comes to you has no privacy. We do corporate funding issues. How do you discover corruption in a corporation? How do you analyze the books? And for that, we bring in criminal accountants who can teach our journalists how to investigate false accounting.
of the British government or the American government simply doesn't get on.
그는 비영리 탐사 매체들이 주류 언론보다는 규모도 작고 적은 돈으로 운영되는 한계가 있지만 독립성이라는 최고의 장점을 지니고 있다고 강조합니다.
As if somebody who gives us money asks us to do something, we have to send the money back. We won't accept the money. Because it has to be independent. And we'd rather have a poorer operation. Than be dependent on people like that. Now this is a luxury, because at least we can say that. Somebody working for the BBC can't say that. They have to take orders. So it's a different world. So we're happier here, even though we don't have, in many respects, much resources. We have to be inventive if we can.
영국 비영리 탐사 보도 매체의 가장 큰 특징은 두 곳 모두 대학교 안에 위치해 있고 학교와 긴밀한 관계를 유지하고 있다는 겁니다.
We work with universities. We're based at a university. And that means that the intellectual resources of the university are open to us. For example, I have a problem with structural engineering. We're looking at construction contracts where big corporations are stealing money from the public to build shot bad buildings. In this case, we're looking at schools, bad schools. What we do is we use the structural engineers of the university and the financial analysts in the business school to help us with that.
대학으로부터 업무 공간과 다양한 지적 자문을 받는 대신 이들 탐사 기관들은 대학생들에게 탐사 저널리즘을 교육합니다. 대학과 탐사 보도 매체 사이의 이 같은 협력 시스템은 정파와 상업주의에서 자유롭고자 하는 독립 언론에게 새로운 가능성을 열어주고 있습니다. 저널리즘의 기본 책무는 권력 감시이고 그러기 위해선 언론의 독립이 전제되어야 하기 때문입니다.
Press freedom embarrasses the powerful if it tells the truth, because the only things that they keep secret are the things that embarrass them. And without that, public officials become officious, they become dangerously brutal, and they're not controlled by the public. So we're the light that we hope that at best we're the light that can shine into the dark corners of the things that the rich and the powerful don't want exposed. And that's what our job is.
뉴스타파 이유정입니다.